You all know, 7th cranial nerve represents what is inside our brain, which is seen on the face. The face is actually the God-given mirror of our mind. So the facial nerve controls all the muscles concerned with emotions as well as the process of talking. Lot of muscles come in the process of talking, that is articulation of speech. So we are going to demonstrate only the method of examination of the facial muscles. So the first muscle to be tested is muscle of the forehead, that is frontalis, part of the occipital frontalis muscle. To test that muscle, this muscle is usually used to wrinkle our forehead. So when we are thinking too much naturally, or we are worried or tensed up, we may wrinkle our forehead. So this wrinkling is happening due to this muscle acting. So just by looking at the face, if wrinkles are present on one side and it is absent on the other side, it means there is something wrong with the facial nerve on that side. So just looking at the face itself, starting with inspection, we have to start from the forehead and look at the eyes, because the eye closure is done by, again, orbicularis oculi, controlled by facial nerve. And then with the facial inspection, we can look at the nasolabial fold, which normally gives the symmetry of the face. So anything wrong with one side facial nerve, you will find the other side will be overacting, and the affected side, the nasolabial fold, will be obliterated. Other side will be overacting, so you will find a prominent nasolabial fold. So the message is, before you start examining, just looking at the face of the patient gives so much information regarding the facial nerve. So inspection is very, very important. Second point is, so start with the forehead, then eyes, then coming to the lower part, the nasolabial fold, just inspection. Second thing is, naturally the patient will be talking to the doctor. So when he is talking, when these muscles are weaker, naturally certain words you will not be able to pronounce properly, and from the weak side air will escape, so that the voice will get altered. So with experience one can easily make out that person is unable to talk properly. That's why in the beginning I said articulation of speech also will be impaired, because without proper functioning of the lip muscles, certain words cannot be pronounced properly. So with that brief introduction, we will examine these muscles. The first muscle to be tested is frontalis muscle. To test the frontalis muscle, you have to, number one, fix the head so that the patient will not elevate his head. So you fix the head of the patient gently and show your finger about 1-2 feet away from the patient and ask him to follow the finger up. So you can see the frontalis acting. Wrinkles coming here, showing the frontalis is intact. Second muscle to be tested is obviously orbicularis oculi, which is used for closing our eyes. Patient is asked to close the eyes firmly. Patient screws up the, closes the eyes firmly, and you start trying to open the eyes forcibly. You can see the orbicularis oculi is very, very strong. I am unable to overcome it. You have to be gentle naturally. So if this muscle is weak naturally, you will not be able to close the eyes properly. So when he attempts to close the eyes, the eyeball will roll up, what is called bell sign, which we will be learning later. So any person when both orbicular and ocular are normal, he will close the eyes properly. You can't see the eye behind it. So after that, you go here and ask the patient to blow the cheek. This muscle is vaccinated, which allows us to blow the cheek. That is also intact here. And as I already told you, there is a nasolabial fold here. All of us have nasolabial fold. The muscle in the nasolabial fold is levator labii superioris alacnasi, connected to the nose. So that forms the main muscle in the nasolabial fold, along with levator anguli oris. So these two muscles form the nasolabial fold. To demonstrate it, you ask the patient to show his teeth. You can see beautifully the nasolabial fold coming up. Suppose one side is weak, this nasolabial fold will be absent, and this nasolabial fold will overact, pulling the angle of mouth to the healthy side. So here it is beautifully seen. Nasolabial fold is very, very beautifully seen. Then you can ask the patient to whistle. This is for orbicularis oris muscle, which helps you to whistle. Okay. Finally comes platysma. You can see it's a superficial muscle, subcutaneous muscle, and like other muscles which are skeletal muscles, this is in the skin as such, which helps us to show like this platysma. So frontalis, you test like this, then ask the patient to close the eyes firmly and try to open it. Then comes vaccinated, blow the cheek. Then ask the patient to show the teeth, look for the nasolabial fold, and then ask him to whistle, which helps you to check the orbicularis oris, and finally platysma, which can be easily tested. So today we will stop at this level. The other sensory test involves testing of the taste in the anterior two-thirds of the tongue, which requires little more time.